Hello and welcome back. This time to our second base element. Yeah? Second base element. This time we are talking about integrational element. Or short, I element. First, I again will give a short example. What is an example of such integrational element? Yeah. So let's imagine we do have a pool or something like this. Yeah. Big pocket. Yeah. Pool. The pool has a certain area. Yeah. A. Let's say these are 10 square meter. Okay, I have a hose and I'm filling this pool with a certain flow. The pool is starting to fill. The level will go up, 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 and I want to know how much level I will have on a certain time. Okay. What do I have to do? What do I have to do? I have to sum up the whole volume which I already filled in, so I have to integrate from zero to the time t, where I'm interested in, everything which was running in up to now. Yeah? And how to, this is the volume, the filled volume, how many liters are filled in. Yeah? And how do I get the height now? Yeah? I have to divide by this, by the area. Yeah? So I have to multiply this with 1 divided by A. And this is h from t. Okay, this is the formula. So if we do, let's see what would be the result. If these are liters, yeah, these are liters per second, these are seconds, so there is left liters, yeah, divided by square meter, so there will be millimeters left. Yeah? This would be a factor, so this is 1/10 multiplied this is the formula. Okay, now again let's have a view on this like it would be a transfer function. There's the transfer function. Okay. There is this I, yeah, with a certain transfer function gs. There is an input again. Yeah. And there is also again, like before, blue, like always, the output. Yeah. So this is xo from t. This is xi from t. Yeah. We use the thin one, xi from t. Yeah. Okay, that's it. Yeah. And after the Laplace transformation, we will have here again xi from s, and again we have here xo from s. Yeah. And then there's this transfer function. We want to know this transfer function. So the input is for sure this flow. Yeah, this is xi. Yeah, and the output, the result, is this, 6o. Yeah. So basically, what is standing here is xo from t, yeah, equals some factor. Okay, so some integrational factor, ki, which in our case is 1/10. Okay, and then integrating from 0 to t, yeah, my xi. This is the formula of an integrational element in time. Yeah. Now I'm going to change this into to the Laplace transformation. So xo from s equals ki, yeah, and an integration. What is an integration? Integration is a division by s, yeah, multiplied xi from s. Okay, so this is ki divided by s multiplied xi from s. Yeah. What is ks now? Yeah, xi multiplied by gs is xo. So gs is ki divided by s. Yeah. And sometimes we are not using this ki, or very often we are not using this ki. We are using ti, integrational time. And this ti is nothing else than 1 divided by ki, yeah, reverse factor. Yeah. So ti in our case would be 10. Why we're using this ti, we will see, okay, when we talk about the step response. Okay, so this is our factor. Okay, this is our fact. This is our transfer function. This is our transfer function. This means our g from j omega equals 1 divided by j omega ti. Okay. Let's see what this means. Let's see what this means. Let's do again the imaginary axis. And here's the real axis, yeah. What does it mean? The angle is of course negative, yeah. So here we're going down here, yeah. Why we are going down? Why we are going down? Yeah. Because this is nothing else than minus j omega ti. Yeah? And here, at this position, we are 1 divided by omega ti, yeah? On the imaginary axis. So our angle here is minus 90 degrees. Yeah? And the higher the frequency will be, yeah, the lower, the smaller this will get. Yeah, the higher, the lower the frequency will be, the longer this arrow will get. Yeah. So, what does it mean for our absolute value, k from j omega? Yeah, is 1 divided by omega ti. Yeah. So, for omega equals 0, yeah, our absolute value, j0, equals unlimited, yeah, will reach unlimited, yeah. For omega unlimited, yeah, one divided by unlimited is 0, will reach 0, okay. And now to the argument for g from j omega, yeah, this is 90 degrees, regardless how long this arrow is, this is always 90 degrees, minus 90 degrees. Yeah? So the argument from g, j0 is minus 90 degrees, yeah? And the argument from g, j unlimited, is also minus 90 degrees. Okay? With this knowledge, Yeah. So this is the transfer function. This is one example. This is the transfer function. This is how it looks in the time area. This will transfer into Laplace area, and in the Laplace area, we can even deal with the frequency response. Okay. Let's have a look how this looks like on our sheet here. So we have an I element. I element. Just transfer the formula. So our GS equals KI divided by S, and this is the same like 1 divided by STI. Yeah. TI is 1 divided by KI. This means G from J omega is KI divided by J omega, and this is 1 divided by J omega TI. Okay? The absolute value from G for your omega is 1 divided by omega TI. Yeah? And the argument from G J omega is always minus 90 degree. Now, here it does not really make a lot of sense what I say now, but I will repeat it, yeah, in every single video until you're fine with it. Step response. You can always remember, yeah, that in steep areas, the frequency, especially if it's a jump, in this exact area, the frequency is unlimited. And now, the longer after a change we stay constant, the lower the frequency will get. So here we assume we have nothing. We're not feeling anything, we have zero. Okay. Here, we have a high frequency, and we said at high frequency, the transfer function, at unlimited, the transfer function is zero. So here, first, nothing will happen. Yeah? And then it will start to fill up. Yeah? The volume will start to fill up, and this will happen linear. Yeah? And now, let's see what must happen. Yeah? What must happen that this is exactly 1? Yeah. We need to wait until exactly this integration time. Yeah. So after, if this is 10 seconds, yeah, we sum it up to 10 seconds, this will, if this is getting 10, this will exactly compensate this here. So we are filling 1 liter per second, yeah? Until when we do have 10 liters after 10 seconds. Okay? So this will rise here, linear rise, yeah? And exactly where I cut the one line, yeah? Exactly here, this amount of time is my TI. Yeah? From my step response, I can directly derive my transfer function. Okay? If it looks like this, I know, okay, it's an I element, I measure this TI, and I can already write it. Okay? And now, let's have a look on the Bode plot. This is easy. Yeah? The argument is easy. It's always minus 90, minus 90 is here. Regardless of the frequency, will stay at minus 90. Horizontal line at minus 90 degree. Check. Okay? Now, how does it look here? Let's think. Yeah. at which frequency this would get worn? How much must omega be to be 1? Yeah, 1 divided by 1 is 1. Yeah? So this means if omega multiplied by ti is 1, this will get 1. Yeah? So in our case, if omega equals one divided by ti at exactly this frequency, if I set this in, ti and ti will get lost. It's 1 divided by 1. I'm at 1. I'm at this line. So ti was 10. So at the 10th, exactly here, I will pinch. This is my omega d. Yeah, I will pinch my 1 line. Okay. Now, let's think. What happens if this omega is only, it's not 0.1, it's 1, 10 times more. What happens to the absolute value? If this is 10 times greater, then the absolute value is 10 times less. If it's 100 times greater, the absolute value is 100 times less. And so on. Yeah. So, and if it's 10 times smaller, yeah, if it's smaller, then this is 10 times greater. So there is a line happening, yeah, and we are dropping. Yeah. And this is a very important line, yeah, especially this behavior that if we have 10 times the frequency, it's only a 10th of the output. Yeah? And we have double the frequency. Yeah? If we have double the frequency, yeah, it's only half of the output. Okay? Yeah? If we double the frequency, we're exactly at the 0.5 line. Yeah? It's half of the output. Yeah? If we only have half of the frequency, it's double the output. Yeah, if you have not 0.1, but 0.05, we are here, and it's 2. Yeah? It's simply because it's exactly reverse. Yeah? This we will use. Yeah? So if we want to know where is 8, yeah, where do we pinch 8? Yeah? We know 1 is at 0.1. Where do we pinch 8? We must be 8 times lower. Yeah? 0.1 divided by 8, 0.012, so here somewhere. Here I reach 8. Okay? Good. This is the I element. Yeah? Frequency response, step response, transfer function of the I element. I can read out the I here. I can read out the I here because it's 1 divided by the I. Yeah? Regardless, from both things I can get to the transfer function. From the transfer function I can get to both things. Okay? I element. So we have now a proportional element. We have an integrator, so we also have a differentiator, and this will be the next element we're talking about. Okay, d element or differentiator, differential element. This will be done in next video. For this time, thank you very much for listening, and goodbye.